In this video, we'll look at creating a very simple project using Eclipse. After I double-click on eclipse.exe, the splash screen appears, and I am then prompted for a workspace folder. Using multiple workspaces can allow you to organize your different projects by category, and not have them all visible in Eclipse at once. I'll accept the default folder and continue. I now reach the welcome screen. This screen has an overview, samples, and tutorials. I'll proceed to the workbench. If you need to get back to the welcome screen, you can select it from the help menu. Now let's write a simple Java program. On the file menu, we select New Java Project. This brings up a screen where you can give the name and location of the project. I'll call this My First Project and accept the default location, which is my workspace. Below that, it asks what version of Java I wish to use and how I want the files laid out. I'll accept the defaults on those and push Finish. Next, I need to create a Java class. From the File menu, I select Class. Eclipse is going to store this in the source folder, and I will give it the name Hello World. I want a main method, so I'll ask Eclipse to create a stub for me. I then pick Finish. Now let's look at the folders Eclipse created. In my workspace, I have My First Project. Inside that are Source, which is where the Java source code will be, Bin, which will contain the rest of the compiled classes. You'll mostly be interested in what is in the source folder, and can ignore all the rest. Back in Eclipse, we can see the created project. There are also windows for task, list, and outline. I'm going to close those to reduce the amount of clutter. If you want them back, you can get them from the window menu, under Show View. You can see that Eclipse has added a lot of code for us, and put a to-do for us to add code. I'll add a println. Notice that after I type system dot, Eclipse shows a lot of suggestions. Also, Eclipse is constantly compiling in the background, so if I type something wrong, like leaving off the N at the end of println, a red squiggly appears under the line, indicating there's an error. Hovering over the red X, I can see the error messages. I'll finish off the code, printing out Hello World. To run the program, simply hit the green Run button. We can add more than one file to a project. By simply dragging a file into the project, it is added. Eclipse is an extremely powerful IDE with lots of options that can be intimidating, but you can also use only a small subset of it fairly easily. You can find more videos at java.mertoncarlyle.com.